Let us take the next question. I'll read what is given here. An open belt drive, 10 cm wide, connects two pulleys mounted on parallel shafts 2.5 meter apart. The diameter of the driving pulley is 45 cm and that of the follower is 30 cm. Follower means driven pulley. If permissible pull in the belt is limited to 180 Newton per centimeter of width, find the power that can be transmitted when driving pulley is rotating at 120 rpm. Full stop. Assume mu is equal to 0.3. This is the question which we have. Whatever is given here, I will write that in the form of data first. An open belt drive 10 cm wide. Width of the belt drive means the width of the belt. It is 10 cm. Connects two pulleys mounted on parallel shafts 2.5 meter apart. X is the distance between the centers of two pulleys. It is 2.5 meters. Next, the diameter of the driving pulley is 45 cm. So D1 is equal to 45 cm means it is 0.45 meter. Next, and that of follower. Follower means driven pulley. So the diameter of the follower is 30 cm. It is 0.3 meters. Next, if the permissible pull in the belt is limited to 180 Newton per centimeter of width. So the permissible pull means it is safe pull. Safe pull is equal to 180 Newton per centimeter of width. So it is per centimeter width. Next, find the power that can be transmitted. Here the question is, we have to calculate how much is power transmitted when the driving pulley is rotating at 120 rpm. Driving pulley means here it is by suffix 1. So N1 is 120 rpm and mu is equal to 0.3. So this is the question which we have. Here they are telling us to calculate the amount of power transmitted. So I'll start with this. Since power transmitted by belt drive, power transmitted is given by the formula P is equal to T1 minus T2 multiplied by V, that is tension in tight side minus tension in slack side into the velocity of the belt. So I'll keep this as equation number 1, because here I need to know what is T1, T2 and velocity to get the answer of power. Next, in the question, they are saying that safe pull is 180 Newton per centimeter of width. This safe pull is nothing but tension in tight side. I'll say that therefore tension in tight side, which is equal to T1, and that is equal to the safe pull, because safe pull is the maximum pull. It is per centimeter width. So therefore T1 will be safe pull value, it is 180 Newton. It is for 1 centimeter width of belt, and here in this question the width of belt is 10 centimeter, so I will multiply it by 10. So therefore I will get T1 value as 1800 Newton. Next, I will use the belt tension ratio, but for that first I need to have the angle of lap. So I'll say that also angle of lap theta is equal to 180 minus 2 into alpha. Here alpha is sine inverse of R1 minus R2 divided by X. This is the formula of alpha. So therefore I will say that alpha is equal to sine inverse of R1. Since D1 is 0.45 meter, R1 becomes 0.225 minus R2 is 0.3 meter, your D2 value is 0.3, so R2 is 0.15 divided by x is the center to center distance, which is 2.5. So from this I will get the value of alpha, which is 1.72. it is in terms of degree. Now we will put this alpha, I'll keep this equation 2 of angle of lap, I'll put alpha in equation number 2. Put alpha is equal to 1.72 degree in equation number 2. So therefore theta is equal to 180 minus 2 into alpha, alpha is 1.72. So from this I will get the value of theta, and that comes out to be, it is 3.07. It is in terms of, first of all I will get it in terms of degree. In terms of degree it is 176.56. next, if I multiply it by pi, divide it by 180, theta will be 3.07 radians. So this is the theta which we are going to use. Now after this I'll say that belt tension ratio is given by, the formula is T1 upon T2 is equal to e raised to mu theta. E raised to mu is given in the question as 0.3 into theta is 3.07. So from this I will get the relation of T1 and T2. T1 is 2.52 times of T2. Now T1 we have already calculated. T1 was 1800 Newton. So I'll say that therefore T2 is equal to 1800 divided by 2.52. So T2 value, this comes out to be 714.13 Newton. Now after getting T1 and T2, since we want to calculate power, then I should also know the velocity of belt which is moving over the pulley. So I'll say that since velocity of belt passing over the pulley, V is equal to pi d n by 60, that is pi into d is given, since d1, here pulley 1 is the driver, so d is equal to 0.45, and here I will write down it is d1 and n1, n1 is 120 divided by 60. So from this I will get the value of V, that comes out to be 14.13 meter per second. Now I'll say that put all values in equation 1. Therefore power is equal to T1 minus T2. T1 was 1800 minus T2, it is 714.13 into 14.13. So from this I will get the value of power, that comes out to be 1.303 into 10 raised to 3 watts, or I can say it is 1.303 kilowatts. So that's the answer for this question. Here they were telling us to calculate the amount of power which is transmitted by the belt drive. That power we have calculated, it is 1.303 kilowatts, and with this we complete the question.